Rent is going up and so are high-rise apartments, with one southwestern Sydney mayor taking a stand against the New South Wales Premier's housing push, warning it could be the end of backyard cricket.
Fairfield Mayor Frank Carbone joins us now. Oh, Mayor, thanks for joining us. Sydney is in the top 20 most expensive cities in the world. I mean, housing is paramount right now.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. We need more housing. But one of the reasons why it is so expensive and why people that live in New South Wales are struggling is because, quite simply, the federal government has tripled migration. So it's providing a lot of competition for our children to be able to get into the market, high interest rates, building costs have gone up. And, of course, the state government has put its brand-new $12,000 tax for every single new unit and new house, and that does not help.
Look,
also, the federal government's put a basics tax, basics requirements when it comes to environmental issues, and that costs another $30,000. So that's $50,000 on every new home for anyone living in New South Wales that they'll have to pay, and then they have to compete with 1.5 million people coming into the country. So we need to take a breather, we need to take a step back, and quite simply, the government should have better planning when they talk about migration. I mean, they've got a housing affordability fund that's worth $10 billion, and you know how many houses it's built so far? Not even one.
Yeah.
Well, and so when you talk about being expensive, the government needs to pull the controls and the levers to make sure their policy actually don't impact the standard of living of people that live in this
country. Well, I think even when they announced that, it was unlikely that it was ever going to happen, especially on that scale. But we need to put migrants somewhere. Where do you suggest they go?
Well, and look, and we should have migration, but understand that migration's gone up from 150,000 a year to 450,000 a year, and that's the problem. And the problem with the state government's housing policy is I'm not against building more homes. We've actually exceeded the state government's targets, especially around train stations, because we think that's where we can put more homes, and that's where most people want to live, because you've got your shopping centres, you've got your transport, it takes away the need for cars, and it makes it more affordable for those that live there. But what I can't accept is that the state government and Chris Means wants to turn the whole of the state into 6-metre dwellings. That's what he's proposing in the R2. The devil's in the details, Carl and Sarah, and people need to get onto this, because when you the family home is dead, because what he's proposing to do is a 12-metre home will be split into two, and all you're going to get is a garage with 3 metres wide, one doorway 1 metre wide, and 1 metre to take out your garbage. Well, I'm sorry. Don't do that to Western Sydney, and don't do that to our community.
All right,
we're worth a lot more than that.
Chris Minns says that you're effectively hyperventilating because there's an election coming up. Is there truth to that?
No. Look, Carl, I've got 75%. I've got the highest of any mayor of any politician in Australia at the last election. I'm not hyperventilating. Chris Minns should be hyperventilating because he's actually a premier that has minority government. He didn't even get the right amount of seats to be the premier, and he got 30%. This has nothing to do with local government. This is to do with people, and he should stop being a dictator and trying to insult people when we're asking a simple question, and that is that we think he's got it wrong here. He should have a discussion. And it's not just me. Don't forget, today, state MPs, Labor, and Labor councillors have come out against Chris Minns. I mean, they're in the same party. It has nothing to do with that. It's got to do with good planning. And it's a shame that he is using politics and spinning things and insulting people just to shut him up. Well, he's not going to shut me up. They didn't shut me up during COVID, Carl. You know that. They're not going to shut me up now.
All right. So third biggest economy in Australia, Western Sydney, fastest growing, and it deserves some respect. Let's see how it all shakes down. Good to see you, Sarah.
Thanks,
Jimmy. In this market, buying a property can be a financial and emotional roller coaster. So what are the biggest mistakes first home buyers are making, and can they be avoided?
So to discuss, let's bring in Domain property editor Alice Stoltz now.
Hey, Alice,
good to see you. What are some of the most common mistakes?
Good morning, Carl. Morning, Sarah. Look, it's never been a tougher time to be a first home buyer, so it's not surprising just how many missteps they can take in this really complex market. Usually, though, the pre-approval, and this is absolutely everything, go to your bank and understand the limit of what you can borrow and also what you're comfortable with, and ensure that that's going to last a while, because pre-approval changes, particularly in a changing interest rate market, so really ensure it's up to date. Also, buying over budget at auction, we know many people sort of think heart overhead and go way too far in advance. And also the ongoing costs of the property you're purchasing. So really understand what you're taking on with that mortgage and how comfortable you are with accepting that.
A lot of trade-offs to weigh up there, but what sort of help is out there for first home buyers?
Carl, there are actually a lot of grants available, so I think people should look in their city what they can get. But things like access to the Help to Buy scheme, you can buy as low as a 2% deposit, government goes guarantor. Stamp duty is often exempt for first home buyers, particularly in most states, Melbourne, Sydney, Brizzy. Grants for new homes, also an extra 10 or 20K in some cases. There is a lot of help out there. You just need to ensure you do your research to see what can actually apply to you.